Thank you so much for being here. This is a very special event. We're so happy to be able to come together for this special presentation as a part of this year's Salish Sea Butoh Festival. And thank you so much to everyone who has supported our festival and all of the community members that are supporting us in making this possible. And we are so happy to have Katsura Khan with us to share. For those that don't know, Katsura Khan is a Butoh dancer and choreographer from Kyoto, Japan, and is part of Japan's senior generation of Butoh. In 1979, Khan began his career as a dancer with the legendary Butoh troupe
Byakusha.
White Tiger Company.
White Tiger Company.
Most crazy company.
Yes, known internationally for their theatrically explosive, provocative, and highly charged performance style. And Khan formed his own multinational Butoh company after leaving the group, and his company has featured dancers from all over the world, from North America, Europe, Israel, Australia, and Thailand, as well as Japan. And for the last 10 years, Khan has organized numerous Butoh conferences in Kyoto to celebrate all of the generations of Butoh, including the new generation of Butoh. And we are so happy to have him here in Port Townsend, Washington, for our Butoh Festival. Thank you, Katsura Khan.
Thank you very much for your presence here. And today, I'm just introduce some kind of how the environment of Butoh coming up. After World War II, a lot of avant-garde art movement happened. So Butoh is one of these avant-garde artwork. However, the leader of Butoh was a dancer. And you can imagine, it's a Japanese Butoh and American postmodern dance has a very similar philosophy inside. So how, why the American postmodern dance coming up? Maybe you have some already knowledge. Okay, we are they are looking for something not dance, something else. We are very tired of arrangement dance. We know the dance, but can we find out another some possibility? So American postmodern dance, they did many experimental work and then created something very interesting work. Okay, and then now I think maybe gradually fade out. And then maybe everybody say contemporary dance. However, Butoh still surviving. I don't know why. So today a little bit more a kind of the Butoh. You know, some art form rising up. There are some kind of social phenomena. For instance, in Europe. World War One. After World War One, Dadaism starts because of that war. Okay, and then this second type after World War Two, lots of avant-garde art movement happening. The artist is very sensitive. So let's think about what's the landscape of Butoh instead of just talking about the Butoh itself. However, I'm not only talking from my side to talk, become very boring. So I just want to ask him more some your kind of question about more someone very much already know Butoh or Butoh dancer, or maybe we have someone who maybe don't know Butoh, or maybe looks like everybody knows Butoh, right? Oh, is it first time to see the hear the Butoh?
I don't know much about.
Okay, you don't know much. Okay, you don't know much. Right? Yes, we already know Butoh.
Yeah.
Oh, many people.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so I think maybe at the moment, can you tell me your question? Psychologically or physically, because of society,
socially,
politically,
everything.
Okay, so maybe today, if we can find out why this kind of movement is coming up, more roots for the Buddha. Mm-hmm. Okay, someone who are more familiar about the Buddha, any question, request?
The word itself,
Butoh.
The word
Butoh.
The meaning. Yes.
The meaning.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, the word Butoh is.
Khan-san, can we use the microphone so we hear you? Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, her request is. The word Butoh. But the meaning. The meaning. Okay, literally meaning. Okay. So actually, the Butoh is since 1959 starts. And then during the lecture, I can introduce who said the Butoh in the very beginning. Because when they start the so-called Butoh, they say a dance of darkness. I don't know this spell is correct. Dance of darkness. Dance, we say, Buyo. We say Buyo. So it's not Butoh. And then, so name is different. And then let's consider about what this. Okay, literally meaning of Butoh, what it is.
Okay, another two questions please, if you have.
I have a second question, sorry. What is, how is Butoh related to the bomb, and is it?
Bomb.
The bomb.
Yeah.
Hiroshima.
Ah, Hiroshima.
And lead poisoning.
Ah, okay, like a Minamata poisoning or mercury poisoning, you say.
Mercury.
Ah, okay. So, Butoh, how connecting Hiroshima, Nagasaki, Bon? Okay. And poisoning. All right, anything else?
I have a question. Mm. So maybe you can share or we learn together how Butoh began in Japan with some important artists,
mm-hmm.
pioneers,
mm-hmm.
and then its evolution.
Mm.
It spreads to other countries and different forms of Butoh, different styles of Butoh.
Mm-hmm.
That's my curiosity.
Okay. So basically, it belongs to history, and then maybe you are more want to identify how it become global,
mm-hmm.
spread out, and then why so many looks like a diverse different way.
Yeah.
Okay. One, two.
I would be interested in how you find the common thread in that evolution. In other words, what is for you the core of what Butoh means to you?
Oh, okay. So more personal question. What Katsura-kan Butoh means? Kan and then Butoh. Okay, Olga, you are the last person. Simplify, because you are talking about the Butoh performer, this performance and the audience relationship.
Yes.
What kind of relationship?
What kind of relationship and what expectations from the audience?
Okay, about the audience, what expect?
What expect
for the Butoh?
What work we need to do?
I see. Actually. If we have a 5 Butoh dancer, we have 5 different way, 5 different philosophy, because Butoh is, they create from their own body. So each person has a different body. This body belongs to the many, many things. So that's why they, maybe one thing could you remind, Roku Hasegawa, she's a dance critics, she said, dance express with body something. Dance express something with body. But Butoh express body itself. So which means dancer want to express something with body, like a painter express something with painting. Sculpture expressed with something like a wood or material. Okay, but Butoh, we don't say express something with body, we express body itself. So, what I mean body? So, another question happened. What's the body? So, keep in mind, this one is a very important question. And if I forget, so please remind me again. Okay. Now we can start. By the way, when we have to finish? Because including I'm keeping want to keep in mind with Q&A.
Midnight.
9:45. We have another 1:45, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I am 9:30,
9:45. Okay, fine. This is organizer expectation. Okay, 10th August. 16th August, we have this kind of fire festival in Kyoto, my hometown. Surrounded the mountain, each mountain has a letter. This is a kind of requiem for the passed away person. Fire festival. Fire festival, we are dancing together, and then the ancestor is coming in, dancing. They don't want to go back, so that we make a fire. And then during the dancing, you push into the fire. And then, burning. So this is a Buddhism festival. Okay, so, but I recommend you to, if you want to come to Kyoto, spring is best. Everywhere is very beautiful. And then Kyoto is a center of the Buddhism. So many temples and shrines, nearly 4,000 in one city. 4,000. Okay? So, more than convenience store.
More than Starbucks.
Yeah, more than Starbucks, of course. For instance, I born in Kyoto, so when I used to play is almost a garden or the temple or shrine. So that's why the god and then the monk is a kind of a playmate. Okay? And then I can say that Kyoto also very much clean and then well organized, the very much nice design come from the China of Tang Dynasty. From China, many monks want to study to Buddhism, so we import Chinese character, also Buddhism, and then we use it. So Kyoto, my hometown, is one of the like this very much well organized places. Okay, and then the Kyoto here. And then this is Akita. Akita is a founder of Butoh, Tatsumi Hijikata. And then maybe if you go to Akita, maybe Shinkansen or blue train, maybe 3 hours. So Tatsumi Hijikata, he born to 1028 and then he died in 1986. I worked with him 1985. I'm almost the last person to study with him for 3 months to go everywhere with Yoko Ashikawa of one disciple. So I got a lot of Zen koan question from him. This is very much complicated, kind of a lot of words, and still I cannot understand. I keep going because of this word. Okay, and then of course we have a co-founder, Kazuo Ono. He died 2010, and of course Yoshito Ono is a son, and unfortunately I just hired him, but he also died 2020. And then Kazuo Ono is come from Hokkaido. He's also Christian. And then his work is very much always something requiem about healing work. Because he wants to be healed. Because he has something problem during the war. So we understand what his theme. So in this case, maybe I can say Tatsumi Hijikata is, this is Tatsumi Hijikata when he young, this is Kazuo Ono when he young. 1947, Hijikata come from Akita. to Tokyo. And then Kazuo Ono, he became a modern dancer. And then his first show is 1949. Just keep, I keep you, 1945 is the end of the World War II. And then, so that's why after the World War II, not only Japan, everywhere have a lot of avant-garde art movement happening for many, many reasons. And then, so because he become a gymnastic teacher, and at that time he have to study to teach modern dance for the student. So that's why he became a modern dancer. And then, this 1949 is the first time when he was 49 years old, he showed a kind of recital to dancing something strange. I don't know, I cannot translate well. But at that time, Tatsumi Hijikata, the Butoh founder, he saw his dance. Such an old man transformed to the woman, and then painting white, and the movement strange, and he got a lot of kind of impact from him. And this is a first idea about Butoh for the Butoh founder Tatsumi Hijikata. So that's why when Kazuo Ono dancing, it was not yet Butoh. But I heard the pioneer of Japanese modern dancer, they don't have a technique, or maybe they throw the technique. They use a body and doing something different movements. So that's why this senior informed me, Khan, in the very beginning of pioneer of Japanese modern dancer, almost everybody like a Butoh. But gradually they start to balance, to change, gradually become a modern dance of influence of Japanese, become modern dance of Western dance. Okay, and then most important is this is Yukio Mishima. He is one of the very much significant, important novelists. He also the quite a strong initiative about the arts and culture, based in Tokyo. Unfortunately, he suicide for some reason. But anyway, he has a book, Kinjiki. Kinjiki means a kind of. So beyond the gender, especially the boy's love story. And then of course, this story is quite, this period is not so much appreciated for the normal people. Okay, but Tatsumi Hijikata and Yoshito Ono, the son of Kazuo Ono, he did 1959, the title is Kinjiki. A kind of homosexual movements a lot, and maybe the audience maybe like this, very small. This is a very experimental work in Tokyo, and then it goes like this.
Stage is very dark. And then sound. This kind of sound, and almost like a naked, actually this is rehearsal. Almost naked guy is carrying something white. And then he comes in front of the audience, and then many audience go. Because they not only surprised, so grotesque, so ugly, they don't want to sit again. And then many orders gone. But surrealist, poet, photographer, they are very much thirsty about something new. The very famous cameraman, they try to take a photo but forget to take a photo. Okay? And they left, stay. And then after a lot of amazing critic, because each person say, never see before. Such a stupid work. Never done nobody. And then that's very important, because not only Japan, never see before, even if in another country, because they used to come to France or around the world, and then but this is very new. Maybe there's something. And then these are kind of intelligent person to write it down something their own imagination with full of knowledge. And then Butoh dancer read it, wow, we are doing something great. So this is start. I don't know, misunderstanding or whatever, because Butoh dancer, they don't know what they are doing. Just very serious body on the stage. And then even if no more people gone, but someone keep watching. So that's a start, and a very scandal always. They keep doing this scandalous kind of work for more than 10 years. Always very stupid, absurd. And then maybe you can imagine, once or twice you can do something stupid work, but how much you can continue to 10 years? So this amount of quantity become quality, sophisticated by many, many critics. And then they are very appreciated. This is something new body appear, new vocabulary, which they are looking for. Because this is one of the important. Now this is important. Gutai Art Association, start 1954. This one also doing a lot of avant-garde movements. And maybe in US, 1950, Alan Kaplow happening. 1950, also end of 50, Jackson Pollock. Okay, 1960, Fluxus is the most kind of look stupid. Kind of look stupid. But we say this is performance arts. We say large P performance arts. Okay, so example, very famous violinist come on the stage, and then they don't play, they just clean the violin and make a sound. Okay? And of course, you know, 4 minutes 33 seconds, silence, orchestra, the conductor, they watch. And then 4 minutes 33 seconds, finish. Okay, so this is the age of avant-garde. Maybe you can see this, you see the John Lennon and then the John Lennon and then one partner,
Yoko
Ashikawa, not Yoko Ashikawa, this woman, Yoko Ono. She's also a very famous performance artist in working in US, Fluxus. Her work is
she was wearing a dress, and
she on the stage showing the scissors, please cut my dress and then bring back. So many people come on the stage and then she becomes almost naked. So this is a kind of period to show this kind of work. And then in Japan, for instance, this is many, many Butoh artists working in 1967, 1663. I said, Butoh start 1959, okay?
And after 1959, more nearly 10 years, it was performance arts. It's not dance, it's not theater, something else. Cannot name it, and only once happening and finish. this is one of the examples. This is not dance, but not theater. They want to do something what they can with body. And then maybe I just show another performance artist. Stupid. What for? And but many audience say bravo because he became a legend after the long time period passing, and then he recognized one of the pioneer of this kind of performance arts, and he show again. So that's why everybody clap and then. Okay, for instance, like this, same. However, if this guy believes something and keep continue to this work, maybe we gradually think. Not only stupid, maybe he has a reason, okay? Maybe he has a very serious reason. Nobody can do something, this is fucking strange work. So to believe, continuity is the power. Okay, and then let's go back. Tatsumi Hijikata lives in Akita, I said. Okay, and then this person is very important person in Japan as a pioneer of modern dancer, named Baku Ishii. He went to Germany to study Mary Bigman. Of course, German expressionism dance is something like against the classic ballet. The flow, because they are the beginning of modern dance, before American modern dance. Okay? And then let's see what kind of dance they have.
Mary Wiegmann believed that expressionist dance and classical dance were incompatible. Wiegmann had settled in Dresden and formed a school and company of her own. She continued to make use of space as Laban had taught her to, adding to that concept the mystique of her instinct and a more dramatic use of gesture. Was found in Wiegmann's choreography, as in the theatrical productions of Max Reinhardt and in the cinema of Murnau, Fritz Lang, and Pabst. The same contrasts in the use of light, the same dramatic use of gesture, the same allure of the irrational.
Many surrealistic films everywhere. So, Bakuishi, the pioneer of Japanese modern dancer, he go to Germany, he study with Mary Bigman, and then he coming back, and then he showing one his work. Actually, this is he did in Germany.
の言葉を残す。義理の妹コナミを連れて外遊の旅に出る。今からお見せするフィルムは、その時ドイツで収録された、囚われたる人という彼のオリジナルである。若き日の石井爆の作風を知る上で、貴重な手がかりとみなすことができるだろう。
He become a big kind of the core person about the modern dance, and then he go back to his own region of Akita, where the Tatsumi Hijikata, Butoh founder, was very young, like elementary school. He Tatsumi Hijikata, he saw his group dance, And then he was very much fascinated. He decided to study dance. At that time, the German dance is very much masculine and strong. And many, like a boy, longing this kind of art form. So this is the start of roots of Butoh. So that's why you saw the Mary Bigman's, okay, I just show again a little bit same, but what's the difference of Butoh? Still, the dance critics, they love it because they can, because the dance critics or some like a critic, they understand the Butoh dancer, they don't know what they're doing. Just body have some reality. And so that's why they start to, each critic use a lot of knowledge to put on something like a very important kind of what they feel. So this is the process of Butoh to develop. So I think we need a good critic. Actually, at the moment now in US, I don't know for sure how many good critics exist. Because I believe American modern dance became very strong in 1960-70. Okay? At that time, they go to the Europe, and then a very strong kind of impact. Because there's a very good critic exist. And then continue to American postmodern dance has a very philosophically society make something new epoch. So at that time, still, many dance critics supporting. We are very jealous because US, you have the very good dance critics. Dance critics always guide the audience what is, and then give some simulation for the dancer. So that's why maybe in the future we need the dance critics. What if you give up the dance critics, create young dance critics working together, or each dancer become more criticized to better way. So this is my presentation. Okay, so 1966, Tatsumi Hirikata, the Butoh founder, he stopped and then he dissolutioned the performance. He finished Butoh, he said. Okay, after this one, this is maybe one of the last performance of Tatsumi Hirikata work.
ヒジカタ辰巳の中期の代表作の一つ、ヒジカタ辰巳と日本人肉体の反乱です。
So 1970s, Butoh changed, very different. One of the hall of Kyoto University is very much avant-garde artwork. Also many like Allen Ginsberg or American avant-garde, they come to perform here.
try to dance weakness. So he did the fast, one day only one piece of the bread, and then reduce his body or muscle, and then he tried to dance of weakness. Thank you.
there's no really good kind of film exists. It's very difficult to, because always be dark and difficult to shooting. And now this is a kind of, not so much people know, but I show. This is a poster by Akira Kasai. He's a disciple of Kazuo Ono. And then 1967, there's a poster, his solo dance. And then this one, he said, invitation for Butoh. Before, they don't use Butoh. This is the first time in Japan, someone, Butoh dancer, use Butoh. This is the first time. So you can imagine, 1959, Butoh start. At that time, they say, dance of darkness. So, Ankoku darkness, Buyo, is not like a Butoh yet. And then when he used this Butoh, Tatsumi Ikata, instead of Buyo, Butoh looks nice. Because Buyo is name come from the Western translation. And then these are kind of Butoh dance, rather against the Western culture. So instead of Buyo, also the sound of the Buyo is, we have Buyo Buyo. Buyo Buyo is like a soft, soft, soft. But Butoh is more something. To is actually step, meaning step, stomping. And then very much like a solid image. So he used, instead of Buyo, of dance to darkness, he used Butoh. And then, since then, Butoh become mainstream of the dance, of this kind of dance, Butoh. And then, after 60 years passing now, even if a modern dancer, they use Butoh. And then Butoh become more like a, in general, something not a kind of dance technique. Because many nowadays, contemporary dancer in Japan, they try to not to use dance technique. So more body based. So that's why nowadays contemporary dance scene in Japan is very similar to the beginning of Butoh work. And of course, still a lot of dance technique they're using. And then maybe this one also nobody not so much knows. This is Ko Murobushi, very young. This is Yumiko Yoshioka, is still very young. And then this is Carlotta Ikeda, is also very young. They appear in Paris for the sake of go to the cabaret show of Moulin Rouge or something like this, but they fire because it was not so good. So they decided, let's do something what we do in Japan. And then they rent small spaces, only 3 days. They're showing their own Butoh work. This is the first 1978, first time in Europe, in Paris. And then French people, they saw it, many newspaper come, and then they surprised them because they cannot understand. And the French people, they believe we are the leader of the art of the world. If we don't understand, this is something new. Because they believe, if don't understand, this is something new. So this is a sense of French people. So this is very important. And then since then, this is the start. This is maybe they did nearly 1 month show after big kind of things happening. Okay, now After this, many Butoh dancers come to Paris and then they show it. But still, they don't understand the because it not looks like a dance. And then let's see. I just want to ask him. How do you think this is dance or what? But they say this is dance. So this is choreographer, not composition. This is a Butoh notation.
Thank you.
Japan, we say, '59 starts, but we have two different concepts. This concept and this concept. This is we say Mao, and this one Odoru. Both dance. If we need to translate. So I think 1907, there's a vocabulary in English, dance. Dance is correct. Translator, the literature, it was very difficult. He used to translate of Shakespeare work. And then he cannot find a good translation vocabulary because in Japan we have Mao and Odoru, two concepts. And Odoru is more, looks like a stomping and then doing something like a folk dance. The another one is no theater. They just simply walk to make atmosphere. So this one, we say Mao. So very different concept. So that's why this literature decided, okay, let's combine this one because this dance looks like two concepts together. He thinks, this one quite immature meaning. Japan, we have categories too, but that's okay. And then they say Buyo. Maybe here. Buyo. And then I said, when start 1959, Dance of Darkness is Ankoku Buyo. But I said, Akira Kasai, 1967. He used Butoh. This is Butoh is more, I think it's ceremony. Ceremony words. There's a ceremony words instead of Buyo. Actually, they come from the more Chinese concept. Butoh is this one more. Legs, this one hands, actually. However, this Butoh is a kind of ceremony work. Maybe if you imagine in church, the monk gives some baptism to have a ceremony, like this ceremony movement in Japan also, temple or shrine, they do some something slowly moving and then doing ceremony work, we say Butoh. So they use old language instead of Western translation work. They use Butoh. So this is the start of language, meaning of Butoh. And then the two lady asking about bomb, Hiroshima, Nagasaki, or Minamata, mercury poisoning. This kind of phenomena, I don't say no, but it's not like the main because war is more serious. And then, for instance, in my personal experience, and I think maybe I started Butoh 1979. 3 years working with Byakkosha, stupid company. I quit to finish, and I focus to working in Indonesia. And then I think 1990s, I was invited in Hawaii because I forgot when, but The one, the cultural officer asked him to me, can you go to the Hawaii to show your own dance because the ceremony in Pearl Harbor. The title is Healing from the Past. So can you go in Pearl Harbor to dance with local Butoh dancer? Local Butoh dancer? What? And there's a two dancer, Tangents and Iwan Pair. They are also one, the Tangents are the dancer is more like a fourth or fifth generation of Japanese immigrants. They try to do something, Butoh work. And I understand, Hawaii is more, for me, it's like a wedding, tourism. But I saw this Hawaii, the fifth generation woman, and I just very impressed because her movement looks like my grandmother's mother's some memento exists. Wow, I should go to meet. And I go there and we work together. I had a lot to discover from the her movement because, you know, Japanese immigrants, they try to keep their own identity, some kind of core ceremony of Japanese, but in Japan already gone. So I'm very surprised and very happy. And to work together, and I did in Pearl Harbor, with many American audience there, and then we are dancing, and then many audience cry, because they saw that someone died because of bombing by the Japanese, like a airplane. Many American soldiers or many people die. Also, someone see the Hiroshima Nagasaki's ghost. But we never meet. We never try to do this kind of ghost work. We just do some kind of dance work. We don't express anything, but audience read it by their own literacy. They translate by themselves. So Butoh is like this. Body has a mystery a lot. So that's why if you more neutral to simply to show, to carry your own something, and then the audience can translate by their own. If you express something, audience try to understand. And then sometimes cannot understand. Or sometimes, yes, I know. But if you don't express, you're just showing body, very honest body, show on the stage. And then go to the edge, audience feel something. So this is maybe one of the important theme. Butoh, dance express with body. But Butoh express body itself. So this is maybe important theme. So that's why if you audience feel poison or bombing, whatever, it's you have inside this. So it's your literacy, you have inside this. That's why you can connect it. Okay, so now another one more, last film by Tatsumi Hijikata's Origin, but maybe before that, I want to show Kazuo Ono's work. How different? Kazuo Ono's work, basically improvisation work. Okay, Kazuo Ono, when he was very young, he saw Tatsumi Hijikata, the Butoh founder, he found Butoh because of Katsura. And then he tried to do something, a kind of strange work for more than 10 years, and then he started Korega Park. And Katsura Ono, he has a big success, sometimes get the Korega Park by Tatsumi Hijikata, my mother, or another kind of, this La Argentina can be some kind of Korega Park. And he had a good success in all over the Europe. But I heard some kind of many critics, or some critics said, I don't know Katsura Ono is really good or dancer or not. But this is my question. I also meet him, to talking with him, have a lot of interview, and then actually, why he dancing Requiem? Because he was a soldier, fighting World War II in Papua New Guinea. And then he take many kind of the soldier, Australian soldier, to go into the jail. But he has no kind of food for them. So that's why he go away in the night. But of course, not only just exile, he just shooting from behind. So he has a very much pain inside. And then he very sorry I could leave and then coming back to Japan. So his old theme is Requiem. Always, I'm very sorry. Please calm down the spirit. And then actually, Ono Yoshito, the son, I invited him to my festival in Kyoto. He said, my father is modern dancer. He's not Butoh, he said. But he dance his own dance. So in this case, if you dance your own dance, can be Butoh. And then actually, I saw, it goes like this. When he was 87 years old, he finally come to my hometown, Kyoto. Everybody, let's go to see him because this 87 years old Butoh dancer, maybe this is the last chance. And we rush to go there to see, and then, we understand. Someone cried, someone impressed, and I have a question. And then, but okay, this is the last chance. But next year, he came again. next year, he again, until I remember when he was 99 years old, Yoshito Ono, the son, carried a holy chair. He just come on the stage, and the music, same music, he started to rising up the hands, to showing, and many people cried. And for me, I have a little question, because gets old. And then actually, I cannot say he's not the Butoh dancer. I have to be 103 years old first. And then I can criticize. And also, his body is already like a Butoh. So if you have a Butoh body, whatever you do it, become a Butoh. So this is my understanding about his work. However, Tatsumi Hijikata's Butoh, some critics in 1990s, many critics gathering, what is Butoh? They identify. Kazuko Kuniyoshi, one of the major critics said, Butoh is only dance of darkness. But he don't say Katsura Ono not the Butoh dancer. She said Tatsumi Hijikata's lineage is Butoh. But Yoshito Katsura Ono's lineage, maybe sometimes Butoh, maybe sometimes not. And the main reason is Tatsumi Hijikata's dance you saw the woman's dance.
Do you remember the red costume doing something strange, face here? They have a choreographer, and then when he doing something like this, this is like this. The choreographer is either very simple. Ear. This ear project to the ceiling. And then they just travel to this here. Ah, tired. So they just traveling to this one. So movement is like this. But when you watch, what's this? Cannot understand. But not boring. So this is the point. And then gradually, if it's interesting, stop to think. And then coming up something, all memory from your body to create your own story. Not the brain. You have a body memory a lot inside. If you cannot identify your whole body to help, and then to try to feel something. So this may be main for me a theme of Butoh. So that's why ideally my workshop, observation, and looking for something interesting. Keep watching, cannot understand, cannot identify what this, like a UFO on the stage. And then not boring, but cannot understand. Gradually you create your own imagination. So this maybe I can call Butoh.
Or your own dance, not someone's technique. So if you found this one, you are very successful. So just keep something interesting. Especially Tatsumi Hikada's dance group, choreographer, is always some kind of funny joke.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight's performance is the second show in commemoration of the formation of the Young Butoh Dance Group. The play Hanji Daito-kan's first part is entitled Ho Sotan, directed by Katsumi Hikada. Thank you.
He using more Hōsōtan. Hōsōtan is a kind of disease. You know the chicken pox everywhere? We don't have a video. We don't have a kind of music. I only know some kind of breathing and then wind.
No, no.
Forbidden color, right? In the very
the
beginning.
One on the video, so it's not the original music.
Which one?
That was
are you from the Summer Storm?
The one that we just watched.
Yeah,
just watched.
Oh, Hosa.
This one, like a Maria Callas.
Was that original music?
Maria
Callas. That is original music.
Original music, yes.
So that one. And so my question was, is that the original music? And Casuono was also using
Okay. No, okay, your question. Kazuo Ono, he uses Spanish music, he's dancing. Okay, he using La Argentina memory, he use Spanish music of La Argentina, she's dancing. This is a kind of memento to dancing, to wronging her. So that's why he use it. And then, Tatsumi Hijikata, he likes like a more opera singer. He feel more deep kind of conflict. Basically, in my case, for instance, as a Butoh dancer, I'm looking for something music which is not so much like talking the kind of express. And then I, for me, movement first, and then looking for the music and the costume. One example, long time ago, I was in Jerusalem in Israel, and then walking in the Golgotha like a street, which the Jesus Christ carried across. And then I heard very nice music, clarinet, very beautiful, very sad sounds. And I jumped into the music store. Hey, master, I like this music, very sad music. Can I, how much does it cost? And then the master said, young Japanese, this is not sad music, this is happy music.
Maybe that's what my question was. Like, what is in music from Spain that was so inspiring for both of them to use?
Maybe Kazuo Ono, he's very much a kind of love. And then whenever he listens to his image, visual image as a memory or music, he go back to his own young age. For me, I'm always looking for something like it depends on the audience. Audience feel sad, audience feel happy. So like a conflict. Like Charles Chaplin, he also used a lot of gypsy music. Gypsy music looks funny, but very sad. So this music is very much good, because I don't want only just showing sadness or happy. Feel the audience. It depends on the audience. So this is maybe one of the choice. Many Butoh dancers I see not like express something.
I have a question. You showed us this very interesting photo from the 70s of three Butoh dancers, Yumiko Yoshioka,
yep.
Ko Murabushi, and Carlota Aikeda, the three together. And so they were the first to perform in Europe.
Yes.
Yes? Like 1978, something like that.
Yeah.
So I have two questions. One, the three of them, did they study with Hijikata? They're more the Hijikata lineage?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Okay, number one, Karota Ikeda, Yumiko Yoshioka, and Ko Murabushi, they were in Daidakudakan. Daidakudakan is, I showed Akajimaro, he's the main person, but at that time, many kind of core member nowadays spread out around the world. Even Sankaijuku, Akushio Amagatsu was belongs to Daidakudakan. And then maybe I think 1970s 1989, I joined in to the Byakusha. Byakusha also, Isamu Osuga, he also come from the Daidakutakan. So at that time, Daidakutakan just find out the partner and then just went out. So the originally, the Daidakutakans, originally they each other looks like a more democracy. As a chairman, Akajimaro, they control, but many ideas come together and then they did a lot of spectacular work.
And Akajimaro Hichikata lineage.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, thank you. And second question. So, from your point of view, Kan-san, do you think that these different Butoh dancers like Ko Murabushi and Yumiko Yoshioka, Carlota, these different dancers, they're like grandchildren of kind of Hijikata, you know, Hijikata, Kajimaro, Dairakutakan, and then they come after.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that they have like one or two elements from Ankoku Butoh, just one or two that they specialize, and then they go and they spread it, and then other people have one or two, and then they go and spread it, and then that's why we have so many different evolutions of Butoh, but only one aspect of Ankoku, only one here, only one, not all of them. Do you think that happens a little bit in the world?
Sorry, your question is, it's a bit complicated question.
Yeah.
But, recall what you're talking about, because you want to say, each Butoh dancer come from Daidakutakan, they took some element from Tatsumi Hijikata,
yeah.
And then they spread out. So they have a different seed, take it, and then flow their own seed. And then each Butoh dancer grow up something different flower.
Yeah.
Okay, so what?
So maybe audience around the world, they only see, they come to performance and they only see one seed or two of Ankoku Butoh, but they don't see all of them.
Yeah.
And they think, oh, that's Butoh,
mm-hmm.
but they haven't seen the other ones.
Mm. So what do you want to do? So this is the reason I invite many the Butoh dancer to come to Kyoto to make a Butoh festival. So now you did it. So this is the most important to gathering to many different Butoh artists gathering, and then you can see different flower, different seed, different idea. For me, it's very interesting. John Nagy come to Japan maybe 1990s. Many American pioneer of Butoh, they come to 1990s and then coming back, spread out, and then they grow up. I don't know the another like a seed, what kind of flower in US, for instance. And then my curiosity is, actually, when John Nagy, she has a video lecture, I want to ask him another one thing is, what did you eat and what you didn't eat? What you refuse to eat? So it depends on the dancer. It really depends on the dancer. Sometimes because you resonate, so that's why you like this one, and then bring back, and then you spread out.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Hank.
Hi. Why, you just mentioned that you found a lot of visitors from the rest of the world coming to Japan in the 90s to study Butoh. Why do you think that is?
Sorry, could you say again?
In the 90s, you said a lot of folks from Europe and America started to come to Japan to study Butoh.
Mm.
John Lennon, right?
Because I know like Maureen Fleming was there for some time.
Actually, it goes like this. Like one example, Mexican. Also, they invite a lot of dancers from Japan. And then I remember the first good Kazu Ono invited in Mexico, it was 1990s. And then, however, in Brazil, there's a avant-garde underground Japanese director exists. He also invites. So that's why in Brazil is the first the region to appear in Brazil.
That's why so much of it developed in Brazil.
So that's why I think maybe many kind of, okay, I said 1978 in Paris, Butoh, first step. And then many people become curious. Okay? And then gradually have a chance to come to Japan. They want to study. 1980, many Butoh dancers invited to France, and then almost sold out all major festival. But they don't recognize this is dance. Always invited like a pantomime festival or physical theater festival, not dance festival yet. So I think this kind of phenomena evoke so many kind of local artists, including, I can say, Butoh looks like a no technique. I can do it. Maybe I can do this. Because without a technique, just show your own emotion or something like something, I have something darkness inside, I want to show, because Butoh said, you can show your dark on the stage. But before, we don't show, we don't intend to something darkness on the stage. Always beauty to the sky, healthy, power. But Butoh is very ground, looks like ugly, not something dance technique, it looks like a no technique, but emotion, face, facial expression, interesting, I can do it. So maybe this motivation is a gate, or the door is very huge, the open. And then someone don't like, they tired, especially I'm a first Butoh dancer in China. I'm a first dancer in Israel, for instance. And then when they saw it, one of the disciples from Beijing Academy, Beijing Academy graduate, and then she forget she don't like the commercial dance at all. So she had another job. But when I come to Beijing and I showed her workshop, she interesting. Cannot understand. But it looks like not difficult. I can do it. Because I want to basically dance by my own dance. Many Butoh dancers say, find out your own dance, not someone's dance. You can show your darkness. If you show your darkness, you become healthy. And then, actually, sometimes misunderstanding in Europe, darkness, they have because of Christianity, demon, Lucifer, or angel. But in Japan, more Buddhist country, darkness is not negative. Darkness means we don't know yet, that's why it's dark. So make grab into the darkness to coming up to make it show. But this is artists doing. Artists looking for the new vocabulary. Nobody knows this one yet. So nobody knows means dark. So maybe this is my understanding.
We have time for one or two more questions. Hold
that. An important question. I have a question. What's the Butoh for you, Katsura-kan? Can you tell us what's
okay, what's a Butoh?
Yeah, for you.
For Katsura-kan. number one. What's a Butoh? Actually, I was a musician before. And in my age, one guitar playing and then make us the poem and then the chanting and then to do something like a, you know, the John Baez?
Yeah.
Something like this.
Folk music.
So folk music. And then once I jump into the musical, at that time, Japanese musical start in Tokyo. And I'm very, someone want to use my music. Okay, you can use it. And then I also join in. And then I'm very much open my mind because musician, you know, musician is very much very narrow. Music is best. Music best. Nothing, anything, no, music. But when they use my music in the musical, wow, music is a part of this society. I just become three dimensions open. Music is a part of this one. So in Japanese music, Japanese musical, scenario is good. And then sing a song, that's okay. We have a Japanese singing. But when I see dance, they use Western technique dance. And then, is there any another dance form? Of course, we have a folk dance, but younger generation, we don't like a folk dance. We don't like a traditional dance at all. Something else. And then I start to decide it. As a musician, I don't like dance, but I better to study. And then I'm looking for the dance work, the very coincidence. One Butoh dancer dancing on the, they come to Kyoto and I just go and I see it. And then this dancer is finally throw the rice cake to the audience. Mm-hmm. And then I just give up. Ah, this is my sense. And I just go out. But in the exit, shame, he's carrying something paper. And then when I pass him through, like this, and then I just catch and I read. You can study any kind of dance. Mm. And then you have a house to stay, and then 6 months training, any kind of dance you can. And then the tuition is very cheap, and then I just go in. So that's a start. 3 days, very hard work with one woman. And then 4 days, she said, "Come, you have a long hair, like you. Can you shave?" But okay, because I decided. And then I shave. And then she said, "We have a job." "Oh, no, Emma just want to study dance." No, we have a job because we did some lot of exercise. And then she take me to the cabaret show. Painting gold and then doing some strange work. So that's a start. But my company called Byakusha, they have an aim to literate, to go back to the Southeast Asia, to looking for the roots of Japanese dance. So this theme was very attractive for me. And then I go to the Indonesia finally, and I just open my mind. I met the many shaman there, and they teach me many things, not only music, dance, theater, puppet, everything. Indonesia was very attractive. So I wake up. So, but the reality is, I met Tatsumi Hijikata finally before he died, and then he had a lot of questions of Zen communication. He make a lot of many different questions, and then I'm looking for the answer for this. So this is maybe I still keep doing my Butoh work. So my journey for Butoh is looking for the answer which I got from Tatsumi Hishikata, our founder. So that's why maybe you want to know what is the Butoh for me. Basically, I like something question. Something question, something cannot understand. I don't know how about time, because when I was 25 years old, I saw UFO. From Kyoto, my job was making a kind of medicine for the pottery to make a color.
Glass.
And then I'm driving from Kyoto in the night, because it was an urgent job. And then next, my friends, he's more high, and then his relatives always fortune-telling woman. This lineage. Whenever I work with him, a bit something strange things happen. So I'm driving in the night, and the riverside, I can see over there the mountain, dark, and then driving, his neck, he's almost like sleeping, I mean, just try to wake up. And then suddenly, looks like a nuclear weapon here. Three times. And I finish, I keep driving. Looks like nothing. And then this strange sixth sense guy, Khan, did you see something? What? You saw something. Yes, I saw something. My skin is like this. And then it was very bright over there, the mountainside. Three objects bring up. And I saw it. But next moment, I forget. So this is my basic question. Why I couldn't recall that? If he don't say anything, I forget. I just drive. And then gradually, I'm thinking, why I forget? And then you know the Trump? Not Trump, Trump? A card?
Yeah,
Trump. You know?
Trump.
Spade A. Spade A. Oh, Spade A, matching. Heart? Five? Heart five.
Oh, heart six, no.
So, my feeling is, I recognize this is pen because I have this data inside. That's why I know it. If I have no data, maybe I don't know. So which means I forgot because I didn't have a data. But he encouraged me to put in a joker in my head. So if I put more joker inside, something can change to cannot understand, maybe I can understand. So that's why the Butoh dancer, you throw many joker to the audience. And then audience, they don't understand, but he just gets something joker inside. And then if he saw something strange, this joker work. Can change something you can recognize.
Thank you.
Anyway, thank you very much. Maybe today is quite late. And then we have an interesting show tomorrow. in the seashore. Okay, thank you very much. See you soon.
Thank you, Kansan. Thank you, everybody.